but ordinarily people see the ball, the circle, the ring or whatever, and never think of the background, because they ignore the background, just as one thinks that you can have pleasure without pain. You want pleasure the figure, you don't realize the pain is the background. So avidya, is the state of restricted consciousness, restricted attention, that moves through life unaware of the fact that to be implies not to be, and vice versa. So now the third noble truth is called nirvana. This word means blow out. Nira is a negative word again, like ah. Vana is blowing. So it's a kind of outblowing. Now, in breathing, you know that breath is life. The Greek word, you may pronounce it pneuma or pneuma, is the same as spirit. And spirit means breath in the book of Genesis, when God had made the clay figurine that was later to be Adam. He breathed the breath of life into his nostrils, and it became alive, because life is breath. But now, if you hold your breath, you lose it. He that would save his life will lose it. So breathe in, breathe in, breathe in, get as much air as you can, and Krishna clings. So nirvana means breathe out. What a relief that was. The sigh of relief. Let it go, because it will come back to you. Let it go. But if you don't let it go, you just suffocate. So a person in the state of nirvana is what we might call a blown out person. Let go. Don't cling. And then you're in the state of nirvana. And I re-emphasize the point. This is not, I'm not preaching, see? I'm not saying this is what you ought to do. I'm simply pointing out a state of affairs that is so. There's no moralism in this whatsoever. It's simply pointing out, like, if you put your hand into the fire, you'll get burned. You can get burned if you want. It's okay. But if you so happen that you don't want to get burned, you don't put your hand in the fire. So in the same way, if you don't want to be in a state of anxiety all the time, and again I emphasize, if you like to be angry, it's perfectly all right. See, Buddhism never hurries anyone on. They say, you've got all eternity through which to live in various forms. Therefore, you don't have just one life in which you've got to avoid eternal damnation. You can go running around the wheel and the rat race, play that game, just as long as you want to, so long as you think it's fun. But if there comes a time when you don't think it's fun, you don't have to do it.